a purpose to love. I just want somebody, body. Treat me like somebody, body. Won't be like everybody, body. All you gotta do is love me for me, babe. Hello Carmelo Squad, welcome to my channel. This will be my makeup video. Let's get started. So we're gonna start off with this primer. It is from MAC and I actually couldn't find my brush, so we're just gonna rub it in our face and spread it all around and put it all over your face. Okay, so this right here is gonna be an eyelid primer, but I use it for my under eyes to lighten up the dark circles if there is any. And yeah. Alright, so now that we have done that, we are going to blend it out with this beauty blender and just kind of get it in there and get all around your eyes. Make sure that you don't have any streaks or marks. Okay, so now we are going to do our eyebrows, and I just use the e.l.f. It's like a pasty dark brown, and I use this little angle brush, and we are just going to outline our eyebrows and fill them in. I try not to do too much, but I did a little too much. And also, I do want to apologize for how bad I am at showing you guys what I'm doing. And this is why I am learning. So this is what we are working with. Okay, period. Let me eat my little snack real quick because I got a little hungry. Okay, so now we are going to use this eyelid primer as well. But we are going to do it on our eyebrows just to give it some shape. And I'm using this brush right here that I usually use for my concealer. I'm just using all the long stuff today. Look, nobody is perfect, okay? You gotta bear with me here. You gotta bear with me. But anyways, we're gonna outline the eyebrow. And again, I apologize for the really bad example that I am showing here. But as you can see, we have a little line over our eyebrow, looking like a little worm up there, same thing. And we're just gonna give it a little shape, you know? Make sure our eyebrows are looking nice and sharp and eyebrow-y. I don't know. So all I am doing here is just blending that out on my eyebrow so it doesn't look like we got a white-ass unibrow at the top of our eyebrows. Alright, so now we are going to grab our concealer, and I was supposed to use this on my eyebrows, but I used it on my eyelids, and I used my eyelid primer on my eyebrows, which was really backwards, and I am just now noticing that. But hey, it all works out, I guess. But we're gonna be using this brush right here and just put it on the little brush. And we are going to rub it into our eyelids and get them nice and light and ready for some bomb eyeshadow or whatever. Alright you guys, my favorite part. We are using the Mischief Minx eye palette. Eyeshadow palette. Oh my god. Anyways, we're going to go in with this little gold glittery one that we got at the top left corner, and we are just going to rub it in our inner corner of our eyelid and bring it towards the outer part of the eyelid. And you can't really tell in the video, but it is on there, I swear. I Alright, so now we have our second palette. This is going to be Naked by Urban Decay. And we are just going to put this color right under our eyebrows. So it's going to be kind of like a little highlight, which I will show you in a second. So I know it's kind of hard to tell and you can't really see it, but I will give you a closer look at the end of the video so you can see what I am talking about. All right, now we're going back to the other palette that we had the first time, and we are going to use this orangey color, which I absolutely love. I actually use this color for quite often. So this color, we're going to use this brush and we are going to put it on the outer area of the eye lid, but we're going to bring it kind of towards the middle just to give it like a little ombre look, which I will show you. Alright, so now we're going to use this like red color. It's like a burgundy-ish color. This is gonna go on the outer part of the eye just to give it more of a deeper, darker look to the orange, and then we'll go to the next eye. For some reason I didn't show it, but I got some goldish color from the Minx palette and I just put it right under my eyebrow where I put the other lighter shade, just to give it more of a glittery look and so it pops more. Alright, so this is what we have so far for our eyeshadow. Now let's get started on our foundation. So for my foundation, I use MAC as well. I'm not sure what number it is. I'll put it down in the description down below. But I like to just put it on my face directly. And that brush that I am holding is what I use to blend it out. So let's do that and I'll show you how to blend out the makeup. So now we're doing our contour. I am using this palette right here that I also got from MAC and it is amazing. I'm using the bottom left color. Go with what works with your tone better. So we're just gonna go right under our cheekbones and do our little line, give it some contour, if you know what I mean. And two new iPhone 11s on us, so you can take a portrait built for two with the ultra wide camera. Oh, that's a good one. So now that we have contoured our cheeks, we are going to continue to contour, and this time we're going around the face. So I start on my forehead and just bring it around my hairline basically, and you just want to get it all around. All right, so now we're gonna do right on our chin line to give it more structure as well, and we are just continuing to contour around our face. So now that we have contoured around our face, I am going to grab a smaller brush, which looks like this, and I am going to contour my nose and give that some structure as well, because we want to look like Squidward from that one episode on SpongeBob when, you know, he's looking all fancy and he had the little structure face. Oh, or like the movie The Mask, you know, the green guy. He got a lot of bone structure. He got some structure to his face. So that's what we going for, okay? Alright, so now we're done contouring and we're gonna get this big old brush and just kind of blend everything out so it doesn't look all stiff and weird looking. You don't want to look all dark now, doing all extra. Now you're gonna look cakey. Don't nobody want that. That's ugly as hell. Okay, so now we're gonna use this right here, which is gonna be Hypothermia. Okay, you already know by Jeffree Star. We finna get this glitter popping because he glittery AF. So we just gonna get this little brush, this little furry little brush, and we are going to brush it on our little cheekbones to give it some little popping, because we already got some popping cheekbones. So let's just make it more popping. You dig? Look at that highlight already. Shaking my head. That motherfucker looking like. We're using these lashes. They are by Mink. They are my absolute favorite lashes. I actually don't know what they're called, but they're popping and they long and they look good. But anyways, for my glue, I use hair glue because I just think it works better. But you use whatever eyelash glue that your heart desires, because that's what this is about, for you to look good. Look at these lashes. They look so good. Okay, period. Show them off, sis. Yup, you better tell them. Alright, and now we are going in with our Damn Girl mascara. You already know. So I'm gonna put this on my bottom lashes just to make my eyelashes look more poppin', because you can never have enough. You dig? So this is what we got so far. I'm just giving you a little look on what we have done. Alright guys, and now for our lipstick, I will be using this MAC. It is like a tan-ish color. Again, I will leave all of the descriptions of what I am using at the bottom in the description box. But we are going to use this color and put it all over our lips. But I will be using a different color, which I will be showing you in just a second. And I'm gonna do kind of like a little blend that will go with our eyeshadow. Look at me feeling myself. Who do I think I am? So, like I was saying, this is gonna be the second color that we're using. This is gonna be more of like a pinkish, orangey salmon color. I don't know how to really explain it, but it goes with the orange that we used earlier for the eyeshadow. And we are just gonna put that on the inner part of our lip and blend it out towards the outer part, and then I will do a little touch up of the tan one as well, just to even it out. But this is basically it, guys. So I almost forgot the most important part. We need our setting spray, of course. from Morphe, and I absolutely love this spray right here. It feels so good on my face, and it works all day completely, no doubt, and it smells so good.
Smells so good. And
okay.
Okay.